Hi, in this video we'll be seeing about wireless LAN protocols, MACA and MACAW. Okay, MACA is multiple access with collision avoidance. MACA protocol solved hidden and exposed terminal. Okay, it is used to solve the hidden and exposed terminal that we saw in the previous video. So what it has? It has something like sends, ready to send, RTS. And clear to send signals first. So how is this? We are just seeing how this hidden and exposed terminal problems are solved. So we have two signals and then these signals are sent first. So this helps us to determine who else is in the range or busy for collision avoidance. Okay, so it uses exchange of two short messages. As we said, request to send. First it sends signals, then it says request to send and clear to send. Okay, so these two are of fixed size. Okay, then when A wishes to transmit to B, it sends a RTS message. I'm ready to send. So RTS message, what is it contains the transmission, duration of proposed transmission. That is, I want to transmit for this much amount of time. That will be there in RTS. Now, if B knows that the channel is free, it responds with a CTS message. Okay, so okay, I want to communicate, okay, the channel is free. Now, it responds with the CTS message. This contains the duration of proposed communication. There also, we have proposed communication, how much you want to communicate, how much time you want to communicate. And here also, you have the proposed communication duration. So, any station that hears the RTS message defers all communication for some time until the associated CTS message has finished. So, now what happens? Whichever station hears RTS message, so all the stations keep quiet for some time till CTS message is given. So, a CTS message defers communication for the duration of time indicated in the CTS message. Okay, so how much time? Which is indicated in the CTS messages, so that till that time all the communications are deferred. So when A is transmitting data, C can go ahead and access the channel. Note B's CTS message may not be heard by A, right? So A is transmitting data, C it can check whether any transmission is going or not. Okay, so now what happens? A is communicating to B, but it so happens that B's CTS message is not heard by A, right? So, station B found that the channel was already busy. Now, what happens? Station B is finding that channel is already busy. So, now what happens? RTS packet may collide because of this. So, A does not receive the CTS message. So, it times out and schedules the packet for retransmission. So now A wants to communicate with B, RTS is sent but CTS is not heard. So what happens? A says, okay, I have to stop the communication and I have to retransmit it. This is how it happens. So MACA, it uses binary exponential backoff algorithm to select the retransmission time. Okay, so B's CTS message collides at C. This would cause C to be unaware of the pending communication between A and B. So, C actually, it may not be aware of the pending communication that is there. Now, A has deferred, no. So, that is why it may not be aware of the communication between A and C. Next is multiple access with collision avoidance for wireless LANs. Okay, so here what happens? Receiver responds with the acknowledgement signal, that is ACK, after data reception. Other nodes in the receiver range learn that channel is available. Nodes hearing RTS but not CTS do not know if transmission will occur or not. Right. So now what happens? MACAV uses data sending packet, right, DS packet sent by the sender after receiving the CTS to inform such nodes for successful handshake. Okay, so you have a data sending packet. So after receiving the CTS message, it will say that we are going to communicate. So please restrain yourselves. Then next comes to IEEE MAC layer. So MAC layer, what happens? This has got distributed coordination function and point coordinate function also. So the distributed coordination function, it is actually fundamental and it is content based access method, okay, implemented for use with both ad hoc and infrastructure networks. It is based on carrier sense multiple access with collision avoidance. Then receivers, here they send an acknowledgement signal if they successfully receive a packet, otherwise the transmitter resends. As I said, we have pointer coordination function. So actually this is an optional one and it is contention free access method, and it uses usable only on infrastructure. Previously we can use it for both, we saw that both ad hoc and infrastructure. Here we can use it only for infrastructure. Then this is an optional one and it is an extension of DCS, right, and provides a time division duplexing capability to accommodate time bounded connection oriented services. Okay, so DCF utilizes, and again the same RTS CTS exchange, to reserve the channel prior to data transmission. So channel is reserved and then only data is being transmitted. So after successful data transmission, an ACA acknowledgement is given from the recipient. So PCF requires one node to function as polling master. Okay, so this node is called point coordinator. So virtual carrier sense implemented using a network allocation vector. So virtual carrier sense is done here using a network allocation vector. So NAV at each node is set to indicate the remaining time before the medium is expected to become idle. So NAV is updated based on the duration information contained in the overhead messages. You will have messages containing how much time is remaining and all that. So actual carrier sense combines nave state, nodes transmission status and physical carrier sense indication from the physical layer. All these are combined together.